She said it's another Sunday night once again. And tonight we actually have two groups of guests, but we're just going to talk about the first one. And actually, the first one is very good. He's going to talk about many things that will interest everybody from all walks of life, any age.
Any age. Actually, it's more about healthy eats. And everyone these days are going organic.
Mm-hmm.
And there's, of course, this misconception that once you go organic, then you just got to be purely organic.
And that's
also
not true? Yeah, it's a misconception.
No, not really. They say that you can't really be purely organic.
Mm-hmm.
It would be ideal, but it's just not possible.
Mm-hmm.
And also, there's also this misconception that when it's organic, it's really expensive.
Yes,
so
yes.
There are, if you actually go to the grocery and look at the prices.
Yeah, it's not too much more than.
No. So we might as well go organic, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And to tell us more about it, we have our guest tonight. And she said that he was her guest in One Morning Cafe. And at that time, she already said he has to be on She Said, She Said.
Right. And she said that he looks like he's a really nice person, which he is.
Yes, I know he is.
Yes.
And I can't stop asking questions about health.
Yeah, she said that she could ask him forever about whether it was health and food, and the conversation can just go on for many days.
There are many studies that have been made about misconceptions, and then later on you find out that, hey, coffee's not so bad, or hey, chocolates aren't so bad.
Right.
You know?
And there are all these like diets. There's the Cohen, there's the one with the blood type, there's the no meat, there's the no carbs. You remember that?
Yeah.
Atkins,
but I guess whatever really works for you, because some diets only work for some people and some diets don't work for others.
Yeah, but today's entire episode will be about giving attention to your body, right? Both our first and second guests will be touching on that.
Yes, and that's not only for women, but also for men and those in between.
Right.
So
in
all
between.
Those in between.
Like who?
Yeah,
never mind.
Okay? So all those things we're going to be talking about here sa pagbabalik po ng She Said, She Said.
Joining us, we're here on She Said, She Said. With us today is our really good friend, Angelo Sungco, who's going to be talking about really healthy organic food from a restaurant that they have in Wilson Street,
right?
Hello,
Green
good
Hills.
Evening, Ange.
Yes, good evening, Miss Cutie, Miss Jackie. How
are you? Hi, Angelo. How are you?
I'm okay. How about
it's
you?
It's nice to see you again.
Thank you. Thank you for having me again.
Mm-hmm. Of course. You know, from the first time I met you, I already told you I want you to guest, right?
That's right. Yeah. And thank you very much.
It's been forever. Ange, what do you have here with us?
Okay. Basically, what I brought here in the studio is just a short sampling of what we have in our restaurant called Sugar Leaf in Green Hills.
Sugar Leaf is in the building of FPJ
and Ms. Susan Rosas. That's
Ms.
correct.
Susan Rosas,
but it's
yes.
It's pretty much called the Health Cube building.
Okay.
But yeah, people know, of course, it's called the FPJ Foundation building.
Yeah, Health Cube?
Yeah, Health Cube. Cube.
Cube.
That's right.
Cube. With a B.
Yeah, because
so Wilson Street and San Juan.
That's correct, yes.
Okay, tell us about the food that you have to offer.
I'm looking at
healthy
the
food.
What are these? Are they rolls?
Yeah, this is actually one of our best-selling products at the store. This is one of our goodie wraps. So, of course, we all know what a wrap is. It's like a burrito. So, it's a soft flour tortilla, which we serve chilled. And what makes
it... chilled?
Yeah, it's served chilled. And what makes it different from other, other soft rolls around is we use an authentic kefir dressing. So,
what is that?
That's the one there in the little container.
Oh, that was avocado dip.
Yeah, it's actually kefir, which is... maybe we can talk about that later. But it's a probiotic drink that we use heavily in our entire menu. So we use it in our drinks, like our smoothies over here, and then the sauce of our goodie wraps, And then we also make cheesecakes out of it. We make desserts. Oh,
wow. Okay, probiotic meaning?
Probiotic. When you say probiotic, it's a species of various species of beneficial microorganisms mm-hmm. that are good for you, meaning it really helps in the in your digestion. So
will it make us go?
It will make you go. It will make you slim. It will detoxify you. And,
but
you know,
are we going to have
down.
To run to the bathroom
it
or
really,
just walk
well,
fast?
Well, it really depends on what your tolerance level is to the kefir. Basically, you know, you try drinking a small amount first, and then you see how your body reacts to it. But one glass is actually enough for you to really experience the benefits of the kefir.
Okay, but what smoothie we do in is this, which I want Jackie
to
try.
Yeah, this is actually our banana mango smoothie.
Oh, but sounds good.
That's
okay.
Right. Because
I'm the food taster here.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. She
tastes
likes
everything.
Tasting,
yes,
yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
And I'm the more
I'm sure you'll like it. Even the kids really like it. Kefir, for some of you who don't know, it's a bit on the sour side because what kefir is actually, it's a milk preparation.
Like yogurt-y?
It's similar to yogurt.
Sour.
It's sour. So what we do for some people who can't really tolerate the sourness
put
of it
sugar?
Is you can put something to sweeten it with, whether
like
it's sugar
Splenda.
Or yeah, or not Splenda. Splenda. Sorry, we shouldn't mention any brands here. But
okay, like
basically we have natural sweeteners.
No processed sugars.
Okay. No synthetic sugar. So what we use to sweeten our products, even our desserts,
honey.
We use honey. But that's also high glycemic, so we can talk about that later.
Okay,
but
we have what sweeteners do we have?
Yeah, we have coconut sugar.
Coconut sugar.
Yes, we have a brand called Sungco here.
And that's good for diabetes,
it's good
right?
for diabetes yeah. because it doesn't make your blood sugar go up when you consume it, but it's natural. It actually comes from coconut sap.
And it's brown, right?
It looks, yeah, it's similar to Muscovado,
yes,
but
yes,
it's right. lighter than that one.
Okay.
Yes.
This one, I mean, I drink vinegar, but this is a little sour
too
for
sour
me.
Too sour for
yes.
you, yes. What we do actually in the store is we let our customers
try it.
No, yeah, well, we let them try it.
And then
they,
you put the Sungco beside it.
Yes,
so
and
they
then
can
we put the Sungco beside it.
Because different people want it different ways.
That's correct. Because when we say it's a kefir smoothie, those who know what kefir is are actually looking for the sourness.
Right.
Oh,
but
okay.
for those who, you know, are trying to, you know, again, be more healthy in their food, is we have them try it in our different preparations. You're actually having there the mango banana, which is actually already on the sweeter side. So but we have the pure
side.
Kefir, which
well,
is just basically kefir. Yeah.
Why don't you taste it?
Because you know that I'm not daring when it comes to taste. I'm like basic.
I will tell you and okay. describe the taste. And
I will trust you.
Yeah.
Kefir, again, so kefir is actually some people call it the emperor of yogurt. Or milk champagne.
Yes, because, yes, it's like a yogurt.
Yes, because when you're talking about yogurt or you know those other probiotic drinks, you're only talking about a few species of the beneficial bacteria.
Mm-hmm.
But when you say kefir, the strain that we use is over 40 different species of probiotics. So and aside from that, you know you're talking usually about only hundreds of millions when you're taking other yogurt drinks. But here you're talking about the billions, so it's really more potent than yogurt.
Than yogurt, so it's actually like a yogurt drink.
That's a shirt. Right. Look, it's
and the taste.
Yes.
Okay, how do you spell kefir?
K-E-F-I-R. It's actually a Turkish term.
Turkish.
It actually means feel good. Because when you
feel
take
good.
It actually feel good.
Really?
I can vouch for that.
It was a little sour and I felt good.
You tasted a bit of sourness, but you will feel good after. But again, nobody's
really
stopping.
Yeah, they have a lot of sour cream in their food.
That's correct. Yeah,
yeah.
They put it in their food. They put it in their, you know, shawarmas and all of those roasted meats. So,
kefir is in shawarmas?
Well, we use kefir in our preparations, but I think in the sauces of the you know shawarma stores they put yogurt.
Can Jackie drink that straight from the bottle?
Yes,
and then
but this is a bit more sour. But you know, again, people
shouldn't
really
we get
have
a glass
different
in
kinds
case she
of yes, maybe,
right?
or a paper bag.
Yeah, somebody might also want to taste.
Course,
okay, what is this?
Sayang.
This is Natura.
And this is one. This is the natural chocolate soy milk that we carry, and
soy
it's organic. So what we try to be at the restaurant is, I call it a healthy eats resto store because, you know, we have a portion there. We have a very nice, intimate, cozy seating for around 20, 30 people. So actually, people can even reserve the place for, you know, baptismals or little family
gatherings.
Oh,
they
gatherings.
Can. They close the whole thing.
Yes, okay. Yes. And then, you know, they can enjoy the foods that we have in our menu. And then the partners at the restaurant can talk about the healthy foods that they're offering.
Okay. So, what about the waiters? Are they equipped like you are and they can explain how?
Yeah. Well, it's in process. So I try to teach them little by little all the health benefits of what we carry in the store because it's a bit technical.
Yeah. Are you there often?
I'm there usually in the mornings, but you know I can be there anytime of the day.
But if it's technical, maybe you can just describe each thing that you offer.
That's correct.
And then they don't have to explain it.
That's
what
right.
What time is the restaurant open from?
Yes, we're open at 8 o'clock
eight
in the morning
to
up to 10 o'clock in the evening, Mondays to Saturdays, and on Sundays from 8 a.m. till 2 p.m.
Oh, cool. Yeah. And you can close them up for parties, right?
Exactly.
I am looking at virgin coconut oil. No.
Oil. Coconut oil. VCO.
Virgin coconut.
Okay.
VCO.
To drink?
To drink, yes.
So
actually.
Not EVOO, but VCO.
VCO, yeah. Well, EVOO is also, of course, it's a healthy
extra
food.
Virgin,
we also carry
yeah.
that in their store. We use that for our vinaigrettes.
Right.
But VCO is actually, yeah, you can take a tablespoon of that. It's very good for you because, you know, coconut, we can discuss that later, it's one of the superfoods that are found in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
When you say superfoods are actually, by definition, it's a food that comes from a plant source that is either, number one, very high in a certain nutrient. Like, for mm-hmm. instance, malunggay is very high in B-complex and iron, all of those things. And then, you know, other superfoods that, you know, have a remarkable health benefits attributed to it. So other superfoods we carry in the restaurant is asahi. It's acai. Some people
acai.
Think it's acai, but it's actually acai.
Yes. Acai.
Yes. It's a berry.
Like acai berry.
That's
yeah.
Right. That's
we
acai
know.
Berry, actually.
Oh, okay. That is an actual
that's
acai
oh.
berry?
Oh, no, it's freeze-dried. So
freeze
it comes
dried.
In a powder form. It's deep purple in color.
Right.
It comes from the Amazon, and it's a very, very potent antioxidant. So
okay.
For those,
yes. Can Jackie try that?
Yeah, we mix that. It's a bit bitter.
Okay.
What you do with frozen acai is you mix it in smoothies. Like, for instance,
right.
the smoothie
like,
you have
like
there.
Does this smoothie have acai?
A teaspoonful is enough. This one doesn't have.
Okay.
We use the asahi for our mixed berry asahi because it goes well with that.
Okay, so say a la peanut butter sandwiches.
A la peanut butter sandwiches. Okay.
I have a glass.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay, for some of
okay, the, that's enough.
That's it.
Okay. So for some people who don't know, actually, it's a bit amazing. When I find out, I found it kind of, you know, unusual.
So think
kefir,
yogurt.
Yeah, think yogurt. And it actually, what do you call this?
Like,
kefir doesn't have an expiration date. Some people say, how come it's based from milk? So
yeah.
Naturally, it becomes and more sour. But actually,
smell?
The...
And when you taste it or when you smell it, it already tastes and smells expired.
That's
doesn't
correct.
Doesn't it smell
well,
expired?
Sour. Yeah,
it's,
if
it's
I had something
like
to get
milk.
The fridge, I'd probably
throw
think,
it out.
Think,
yeah.
Think
yeah.
Twice
when
about
in doubt,
it.
Throw
check.
It out.
Sour.
Okay. Are you
but
sure
the thing
is not expired?
No, it's not. Actually, what happens with kefir is as long as you keep it in the refrigerator, it will just get more and more sour over time.
Right.
But it's actually the probiotics in it that is actually causing the sour taste.
Do you want to drink the chocolate milk?
Yeah, I'm sorry?
Jax, you want to try the chocolate milk?
Okay, I'll try anything. Okay, Pucky. What? We're going to mix it with this? That's okay?
Maybe we can rinse the
okay.
glass out.
Okay.
We can rinse
but
this.
But anyway, going back
I
to the...
I can do some magic while before we...
Yeah, going back to the kefir, again, you know, I see your reaction, and you see some people react the same way. Some people even ask, has it gone bad or something? And we tried it, you know, it really tastes
like
fact,
that.
In fact, it's still even mild because it's really freshly prepared.
Okay.
So the more it stays in the refrigerator, it's just going to get more and more sour over time. But for some people who, you know, some people really buy the big bottles because, you know, of course, it's cheaper. And they really consume it every day. You know, mm-hmm. they consume a glass
who?
Or two
who
glasses.
Who are the people that buy
okay,
young,
I have to go
old
to the
men?
No, I don't have to go to the
I had a little amount.
No, what are the people that okay. the... Your clientele, are they younger, older?
Okay.
Are they like mostly those that are
the female
a little
or
overweight
male,
or those that are really sticky?
Okay, you really have a big variety or, you know, how do you call that, the segment of our
okay,
of
for
our
the
market.
Regular buyers of the milk.
The kefir, yeah. Basically, the people who take our kefir are basically, yeah, I mean, you're correct. The people who are trying to lose weight because it's a probiotic, it promotes weight loss through detoxification and making your intestinal system work really, really well. So, of course, you know, a lot of people say that, you know, most people get sick because of they don't have a very good digestive system. So if we address all of the, you know, all of the you know, things that are going wrong with your digestive system, it's really going to address a lot of, you know, other related health problems.
So, Angelo, this comes in plain mango, strawberry, mango, and vanilla.
That's correct. Uh-huh. Okay, but,
well,
you know...
Banango.
Banango, that's banana mango, which is, I think, yeah, which is what you had.
That's that one.
Oh,
yeah,
right. Okay.
Banana,
yeah,
mango. Right. Banango.
And the people that buy your products are the same ones that dine in the restaurant?
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, and we also even have quick delivery. So, 212-1212.
What's the minimum for delivery?
212-1212, that's yours.
That's correct. I mean,
212-1212. How many 2-1s?
2-1-2-1-2-1-2. So seven digits. Yes.
And then I see a motorcycle with that.
That's correct. Yeah. So we just recently signed up with them. So, you know, because a lot of our customers, you know, they always ask us, they want to purchase the menu items or even the grocery items. So those are available on quick delivery through.
More Filipinos and foreigners, or
it's
same?
A mix. I mean, it's a mix of foreigners and locals. Foreigners usually buy the superfoods. They're so shocked and amazed that they see, you know, a good range of superfoods in our mini mart. And also,
we have a mini mart.
So beside the restaurant, there's a little portion there, 2-3 shelves that contain the healthy food items there that people can take home and, you know, prepare for themselves at home. And we also have organic produce, which we can maybe talk about as well later.
Okay, Angelo, you're gonna explain to us all these other products we have in front, and I am really willing to taste all of them. But we're gonna do that when She Said returns. And she said, okay, I'm excited to know what are all these other things.
If you're just joining us, we're talking about eating healthy and the products that can help you eat healthy with Angelo Sungco.
That's right. Okay, well, what we have here on the table is just, you know, some of the items found in our menu as well as our mini mart. So, you know, we talked about the kefir. So again, you know, don't be afraid about, you know, consuming kefir, because no one's really stopping people from, you know, mixing whatever fruit that they want with it. So for instance, me personally, I like it with banana and mango, because it really tones down the sourness of it. And, you know, if you still find it sour, just sweeten it with sugar.
Right.
So, you know, the probiotics are still there as long as you don't heat it. So heat is the enemy for kefir, or even other probiotics.
So just don't heat it.
Yeah. So I mean,
cold is okay.
So what happens when you heat it?
It will really makes your intestinal system work overtime and really nourishes you at the same time, because probiotics help you with digestion. But, you know, what's good about it is it's nourishing as well.
Why do you call it forbidden rice?
Forbidden rice. Okay. Well, that's basically just what they call this particular type of rice. It's a bit on the dark color. So when you cook this, you have to use a lot more water than usual.
Like
there
twice
the
amount of normal water?
It says in the package you use 2.5 to about 3 times as much rice. And this is a bit on the glutinous texture.
There.
So, yeah, this is the forbidden rice.
So it's glutinous.
Yes, but again, you know, if you cook it, it's a bit, you know, a bit tough. So add more water if you want.
What's it taste like?
Yeah, it's rich in iron.
It's rich in iron. It's rich in fiber. It's malagkit. So what you can probably do with it, you can be creative and make dessert preparations out of it. Maybe
so
put
not
some
to be,
coconut
the forbidden
juice.
Rice is not for meals.
I think you can. Well, you can. Somebody told me, a chef told me that what she does with dark colored rice is like rice like this. Is she mix one part of the dark rice or the black rice with normal white rice. And then cook it the same way. Or you can make it into a salad, a rice salad.
Okay.
Rice salad.
And
okay.
Here, right.
This one you can use for biko.
Biko, yeah. That's right.
Because it's already
brown. Yeah, yung malagkit. Yeah.
Malagkit. So you put coconut milk and, you know, something to sweeten it.
I love that.
You know.
Oopsie. And there. The berries.
Okay, this is some of the, you know, the more exotic items that we carry in the store.
Goji
berries.
Knows that berries are antioxidants.
That's right. So this one actually grows in the Himalayan. So it's called the Himalayan superfruit. It's certified organic there in the packaging. So basically, this one is also one of the very powerful antioxidants that we carry. It just tastes exactly the same as raisins. But oh, it's, okay. It has a
so
lot
can you
more.
You put it in salad as well.
We can put it in salads. You can use it for baking
chia.
And
what
for desserts.
I won't taste this anymore because it's still close. Kakahiya.
What's chia? Tea?
Chia. Yeah, I'll leave that with you. You can bring that home. You can. It's very easy to mix superfoods. You can. It's very easy to incorporate superfoods in your diet. So
is it tea?
Yeah. No. It's chia. Is actually it's a ground. Well, this is the whole seed. Chia is actually a seed that grows in a weed or a little grass in South America. So if you're all familiar with psyllium husk.
Yes, psyllium
husk is a colon cleanser, right?
Yes.
So you take it and then it really flushes out your colon. But that's pretty much the health benefits of psyllium, just fiber, nothing else. But chia seeds, actually, it comes in this form, the whole seed or the ground seed. Basically, it aside from the fact that it cleanses out your colon, it's very nutritious as well. In fact, chia is one of the foods that the Aztec warriors consumed during the times that they were in their wars.
Because
it was very light. So they just carried, you know, that, and then, you know, it's very nourishing. So they eat that.
So how do you eat this?
You mix a teaspoonful, basically similar to chia, goji, asahi, malunggay powder, just a teaspoonful.
Heaping or level?
Maximum, yeah, heaping teaspoon. Or if you really want the more health benefits out of it, just take one tablespoon. That should be enough for you for the day.
Put it in water
for,
and
for
mix?
Chia, mix it in a bit of water. So it's going to, you know, it's going to form a gel.
So not hot water.
No, not hot water.
Yeah, it's going to form a gel and you have to drink it right away.
No, not necessarily. That's psyllium. Basically, chia, you put it in water. It's going to form like a gel.
So room temperature water.
Yeah, room temperature water,
like
cold water. It's going to form a gel.
It.
And then you can mix it.
Then put it in your hair.
Yeah, put it in your juice. Put it in a smoothie, put it in your oatmeal and your cereal for an added texture, because it's a nice texture and it doesn't taste like anything. So don't worry that it's going to taste, you know, kind of strange or something.
So you can actually put it also in food?
You can put it in food. In fact, some people put it in salads or salsa because, you know, it adds a nice little crunch to it.
So if you think this is cheese,
it's
like
not.
Jack and
it's
I
not,
thought,
yeah.
You are so wrong.
That's actually cacao butter, raw cacao butter that comes from Indonesia. So actually, if you've seen white chocolate in the stores, that's actually pretty much the main component of white chocolate. But the different thing about cacao butter, that's pure cacao butter. So, you know, the ones that you see in the store are already mixed with milk and a lot of sugar. So the way raw food is, when you say raw food is, these are people really don't consume anything cooked.
Look, Jackie just took another sip of the banana mango.
So she liked it.
Okay, now that you took a sip, it's time to taste this.
Yes.
What do you call this again? The roll?
The roll? This is
I'm glad I didn't have dinner tonight.
What is this again? This is our
cucumber?
This is our chicken. This is our chicken goodie wrap. So
it's
the wrap is made from wheat. It's a wheat tortilla. And then what you see there inside is the organic lettuce. There's also organic cucumber. And then free-range chicken. This one won't make you, you know, cringe or anything.
So this one, you sell also the organic vegetables
That's
in your shop.
That's correct.
There you go.
Yeah, so basically, you know, the organic, you know, vegetables, usually you see them in weekend markets.
Right.
So what we really wanted to do is make it available. Make it available. People really like that.
Don't talk with your mouth full.
You try one, Miss
I know, that's why you're not. She said it's really good.
And
I understand
that sauce,
her.
That sauce has kefir in it. So, you know. Yeah. People
and
buy that by the bottle. But we only bottle it. We only bottle it when people want it. Because, again, it's a live probiotic. So there's gas. So you have to, you know, you have to.
Okay, this is something we know.
Santol
jelly.
Yeah, so we have santol jelly.
Yeah,
we also have guava jelly and jam.
Guava jelly, so they put this on bread or on crackers?
Yeah, you can put that on bread. We use that actually in one of our sandwiches called the mixed berry and arugula sandwich. That's a vegetarian item that we have in the store. So that particular sandwich, it's served in a wheat baguette. And then we spread a little bit of the santol jelly on the bread and then toast it. And then there's arugula, which is a green leafy vegetable that's a bit on the sour side. It really balances off the sourness of the arugula. The bitterness of the arugula. And there's sweet berries on that as well.
Organic lemongrass, where do you use this?
Okay, organic lemon, that's a concentrate. So just basically a teaspoonful in either hot or cold water. And you have a very nice refreshing drink for summer. Or if it's cold, you
drink.
Put it in hot water, you make it into a nice salabat. And you can use that as a little syrup for pancakes, or you can use it also to flavor whatever food you want. It's a very nice
lemongrass taste. Lemongrass, for some of you who don't know, it's also a detox food. It's actually what they feed the free-range chicken and pork that we carry before they, you know, process it. Mm-hmm. They feed it with lemongrass, so it will expel out all of the...
That's the drink for some Thai people, right? Lemongrass.
That's right, yeah. Lemongrass tea, lemongrass chicken.
So do you make baskets for Christmas?
Yeah, actually what we have here, you know, it's already, you know, the September months, very soon.
September, November, December.
So we carry, you know, mostly, you know, what do you give? I have a question. What do you give people who pretty much have everything?
Love.
Yeah, love, aside from love. Something material.
Gift certificates.
That's correct. But, you know, for most of these people who already have everything, you know, they get baskets filled with wine, canned goods, cheeses. You know, that's pretty much standard or expected. Why not give something that really gives them good health? So what we can come up with baskets that really contain of contents that really are suited for the person you're giving to. So we can compose a basket that's full of, you know, foods that are good for diabetics or foods that are suitable for people who are lactating moms. You can have a nice basket full of malunggay powder and then the organic soy milk. And then, you know, other things. So
that's true. Can you imagine if you give someone a gift bag and they can't eat the chocolate, at least this one, it's good for their health.
Yeah, for some people who are diabetic, we can put, you know, natural sweeteners, nothing chemical, nothing, you know, those fine white powders you see all over the place. We don't carry that in the store. Instead, we have other healthy, low glycemic, diabetic friendly sweeteners.
Okay, Angelo, now that I can talk because I don't have any food in my mouth. Okay,
it's
what
time
is,
to pop
what
another.
Is that again that I dipped it in?
Yes,
it's really
it's
good.
It's called our authentic kefir dip.
But so it's a little sweet.
It has kefir and it has, you know, what tones it down is we put some cucumbers and herbs.
Okay, but how come it's a little sweet?
There's something else that we put in there, not sugar, but something just to really tone down the sourness of it. But it still has the probiotics in
it. I love it.
Yes.
I really
Thank
love
you.
It.
So okay,
you
now
don't
you
love
know what to order when we go to this restaurant.
No. I think all these other things are acquired tastes because generally, many people like yogurt, right? My children love yogurt, but I find yogurt a little too sour. Okay,
correct.
But I drink vinegar. Okay, so I'm okay with sour, but I'm not just used to eating like sour
You're
milk.
Gonna confuse the people. They're gonna think you drink vinegar as a normal drink.
No.
She can drink vinegar. Like
No. But after eating the food, I drink the vinegar.
No, like we
after.
Eat cinca mas and with vinegar, and then we drink the vinegar.
The vinegar
after.
Also, yeah.
That's what she means. She doesn't drink
but
vinegar
I think
on a regular basis.
I could acquire.
I hope
the
vinegar you're tasting is organic because again,
no way.
You know, organic versus inorganic or traditionally or conventionally grown vegetables. I mean, let's say you really want to explore eating a lot of vegetables in your diet. But if your vegetables, you don't know where it comes from, it might be loaded with a lot of pesticides, herbicides, fertilizers. So, you know, basically you're consuming those things as well. And, you know, these things leave residues in your body. That's usually what causes a lot of bloatiness.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, a lot of, you know,
puffiness.
Water retention
bloating,
in your, a lot of water retention. So basically when you're consuming organic produce, it, you know, you're not only talking about fruits and vegetables, but even chicken, pork, even fish, as long as they're not fed with artificial, you know, man-made ingredients, those are what you call organic foods. So those don't leave you any harmful residues in your body. And you're just basically eating Mother Nature fed these things.
I'm going to ask you who Dr. Jerry is.
Yes,
but
I already feel thin. No, we're going on a break and he's going to tell us who Dr. Jerry is while I'm going to eat another wrap.
Organic, free-range chicken. Goodie wrap.
Chicken.
Goodie wrap.
Goodie wrap is really goodie.
Goodie,
okay,
thank you.
We'll be back here on She Said, She Said.
Joining us, Jackie just had another bite. It's, you know how there's no continuity because Derek had one and Jackie had one and then Jackie was drinking it.
Had another, then I drank the salt.